Hello, I'm Mike, and today we're going to learn how to fix the WordPress max execution time fatal error. You'll occasionally encounter errors or warnings in WordPress. One of these errors is the WordPress max execution time fatal error. The good news is that this is a common error and it doesn't occur often. But when it does, there are several quick solutions. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there will be links to more resources in the video's description below. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Now, let's dig in. The WordPress max execution time fatal error looks like this in your WordPress admin dashboard. The entire error message reads, "Fatal error. Maximum execution time of 30 seconds exceeded." The 30 seconds value can be any number. Usually, it's between 30 and 60 seconds. This error is prone to pop up when installing or updating themes, plugins, or WordPress core. Every WordPress site has a maximum execution time limit for processing server requests. It's meant to minimize server abuse. This limit looks at all the PHP scripts running on your site and blocks those running past the time limit. Because WordPress sites' files mainly use PHP, it's essential to keep an eye on PHP scripts to see if they run for too long and eat up too many server resources. It's not uncommon for malicious attacks to utilize never-ending PHP scripts to bring the site to a crawl. Besides, some plugins, themes, or other WordPress elements constrain server resources if they take too long to run. Plugins seem to trigger this error more often than other elements, likely because WordPress users install plugins more frequently than they modify code or install themes. Furthermore, plugins come from all sorts of developers, so it's harder to check out the good ones backed by solid code and frequent updates. Regardless of the cause, there aren't many reasons to have a PHP script running for a significant amount of time. Therefore, a maximum execution time limit is in place. Your hosting company usually sets the limit at the server level. Most hosting companies enforce a max execution time that's anywhere between 30 and 60 seconds. This range gives your PHP scripts enough time to complete their jobs, even if they take some time to execute. In general, a 30-second time limit should work well for high-quality PHP scripts. However, you may need to increase the limit to 60 seconds, depending on your code and server response. Some developers may opt for as much as a 300-second maximum, but anything over that isn't a wise decision. You may wonder, is it possible to have a website where PHP scripts take longer, yet they don't cause any harm to the server? The answer is yes. Some resource-heavy websites can't help but reach longer execution times. However, it would be best to assume that maybe a plugin, theme, or other integration is causing the problem before jumping to a different, less savory conclusion. It's also possible your site may require a more powerful server, especially if you currently utilize a shared hosting setup. Sometimes hosting companies may set the maximum execution time too low for your site. It's a pretty common situation, and you can resolve it by reaching out to your hosting provider. The fatal error text sounds urgent, but your website isn't at risk of never working again. The max execution time WordPress error is one of the most common warnings seen in WordPress. However, you may find a message on your site's front end telling users that the site is experiencing technical difficulties. That's a problem. You could lose sales, leads, or readers if the warning message blocks your content and remains active for any length of time. The primary way to see if you've exceeded the maximum execution time is by checking for the message in your dashboard while uploading a plugin, theme, or WordPress update. The installation or update page renders information about the change and gives you a success or failure message. The fatal error message is an option as well. Another way to identify a maximum execution error is by seeing the front-end message to users, which reads, "The site is experiencing technical difficulties." There are other variations of this message, some of which talk about critical errors and include a link to learn about debugging. Finally, WordPress usually sends the site admin an email explaining that a plugin or theme has caused a fatal error. This email will also provide a link to help you find a solution to the problem, usually by deleting the problematic plugin or theme or increasing your maximum execution time limit. As mentioned, the max execution time WordPress error appears after a plugin, theme, or WordPress update takes too long to run a PHP script. You'll see the error notice in several areas. If you have trouble accessing your website, the fatal error email you received has a link to launch your WordPress in recovery mode. There are several ways to fix the max execution time WordPress error. First, identifying and uninstalling the plugin or theme or other resources that caused the error in the first place. It's done in recovery mode or by removing the plugin via FTP. Second, increasing the max execution time in the WordPress dashboard through a plugin. Third, modifying the maximum execution time in wp-config.php file. Fourth, increasing the max execution time in the htaccess file. Fifth, changing the max execution time in the php.ini file. And sixth, asking your hosting provider to increase the maximum execution time. Uninstalling a plugin or theme is often the fastest method, but we'll cover all the options below. This solution removes the max execution error, but it doesn't increase the max execution time. Therefore, it's only a suitable option if you decide you're willing to find a replacement for the offending plugin or theme. Those interested in removing the problem item, like the theme or plugin, follow these directions. To begin, do your best to identify where the trouble's coming from with the following methods. Uninstall the most recently installed item, especially if the error occurred right after installing a plugin or theme or updated to the most recent version of WordPress. Check your email inbox to see if WordPress sent you an email about the fatal error. Sometimes they include information about which plugin caused the problem in the first place. If you have no idea which item caused the error, we recommend deactivating each plugin, then reactivating them one by one, refreshing each time to catch which one creates the error. After you identify the problem item, you should uninstall it from your WordPress site. To complete this process, read our article on uninstalling a WordPress plugin linked in the video description below. The guide highlights how to remove a plugin using the dashboard, an FTP client, and more. Uninstalling via the dashboard makes the most sense for rapid removal, but uninstalling a plugin or theme via FTP comes in handy if you can't gain access to the WordPress dashboard. You'll also have the option to get into the dashboard using recovery mode. WordPress includes a link to the recovery mode in the email you receive. Finally, you may find that a recent WordPress version upgrade caused the error. Use our guide on how to downgrade the WordPress version to troubleshoot this, linked in the description below. In general, the WordPress version shouldn't be the root cause. It's usually a plugin or theme that isn't working well with the new WordPress version. Another option involves increasing the max execution time to give the PHP scripts in your plugins and themes more time to work. Again, the maximum execution time is there for the security of your site and server, so it's best not to increase it to accommodate a poorly coded plugin or theme. However, you may find that your hosting company sets short execution times, or you may need a little extra time. In those cases, it's acceptable to increase the max execution time to get rid of the WordPress max execution time error and to minimize the chances of the error coming up again in the future. One way to change the max execution time is by installing a plugin via your dashboard that makes changes to configuration files without you going into the WordPress files. We like this option for those not comfortable using an FTP client, but only if you have access to the site's dashboard. Some security and optimization plugins like Google PageSpeed Insights have options to increase the max execution time. Another plugin that's focused exclusively on the max execution time is called WP Maximum Execution Time Exceeded. We recommend trying this one out since it automatically rewrites the htaccess file to increase the maximum limits. There's nothing to do on your end. Install and activate the plugin to make it work. By default, the plugin provides a 300-second delay instead of whatever you had in the first place, which should give your site's theme and plugins more than enough time to run their PHP scripts. Finally, uninstall the plugin if you ever want to remove the increased time limit. Each of the following methods taps into your core WordPress files. We recommend accessing your WordPress site files via FTP or SFTP and modify the content within them. As for handling the WordPress max execution time error, one way to solve the issue requires you to open the wp-config file. Open an FTP connection to your WordPress files. Find and open the root folder, usually named after your site, and click on the public folder. The public folder contains an extensive collection of core files, including the wp-config file. Click on the config file to either edit it directly in the FTP client or save it to your computer for editing. Place this following bit of code in the wp-config file. It usually doesn't matter where you place the code as long as it doesn't modify anything already in the file. We recommend finding the last area right before, stop editing, and putting the code right there. After that, save and upload the new wp-config file to your site via FTP. The new maximum execution time for this example is 300 seconds, but you can modify that number depending on what you need. To make sure it worked, go back to WordPress to see if everything is now functioning. If the error doesn't appear when you try to upload a plugin or theme, you've succeeded. Kinsta doesn't provide an htaccess file. since we use more performance-friendly Nginx servers, which don't require htaccess files. Many other hosts, mainly shared hosting providers, still utilize Apache servers and therefore provide an htaccess file with your root WordPress folder. You can find that file much like you would the wp-config file, by connecting your site via FTP and looking under the public folder. Again, you won't be able to find it if you're hosting your site on Kinsta. We recommend using the wp-config method for all Kinsta users. It's essential to back up your htaccess file before editing it. Once backed up, open the file for editing and add this line to the file. Feel free to change the number to whatever maximum execution time you desire. Please save the file and upload it back into the public folder in the FTP client. Finally, go back to your website to check if the matter has been resolved. Another file that's not as common with web hosts is called php.ini. It's another option for increasing your execution maximum, but more often than not, you'll have an easier time using the wp-config method. Yet, if you're sure a php.ini file exists in your root folder and the other methods don't work for some reason, consider tapping into this file instead. Much like other methods, you can usually find the php.ini file in the public folder. Access this by going through an FTP client and open that file for editing. You want to add this line to increase the maximum execution time. As always, change the number to meet your own needs, and remember to test out if it worked by re-uploading the problem item and checking to see if all the error messages have gone away. Running a WordPress site on a dedicated server means you have complete control over the maximum execution time. Therefore, the previous method should work. You also may find that you can manually change the max execution time with other types of hosting like managed or VPS hosting. Many shared hosting companies restrict your ability to modify the max execution time limit to protect the overall server being shared with many other apps and websites. If you either don't want to mess with it or you're having trouble increasing the max execution time, you must contact your hosting provider and request they increase it for you. Reach out to your host support team and tell them you see the WordPress max execution time error. Then, ask what your current max execution time is. Finally, request that they increase your time limit, preferably to somewhere between 60 and 300. Remember that you should remove any plugin or theme that takes longer than that. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. Let us show you the Kinsta difference. Try a free demo of our My Kinsta dashboard at demo.kinsta.com. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.